Hi, I'm Brent Green, and welcome to another great episode of The Green Scene. Today's guest is Tajai of the legendary Hieroglyphics Crew, and he's going to fill us in on our 20-year history. GreenSceneTV.com.
They gonna make you run it, and it ain't too funny. In fact, it's tragic. They dealing in the blackest of magic out here making packs satanic and act straight savage and pack they cannons and hang in the shadows awaiting the battle. He can't be that old, but yo, he's thinking like an adult and things that get handled and lives get lost when that fire gets tossed and mamas a cry because their youngins have died. Turf dance at your wake, shirt scan, got your face and your name up in quotes. That boy came up short. We thug for this paper, slap dubs on a scraper. We struggling to make it. No love, man, just hatred. And every hood cracking with heavy foot traffic. You better get graphic. The devil just laughing.
We're here with Tajai from the legendary Hieroglyphics Crew and Souls of Mischief. Tajai, we'd like to thank you for being on the show today.
One love. Good to be here.
So we want to dive right into what's going on because from what I noticed on the webs, there was it looks like you all are celebrating the 20th anniversary of
Still Infinity, baby. 20 years later, you know, we're doing the Still Infinity tour, 55-60 dates in the U.S. Then we're gonna do Europe and Canada and Japan, and just, you know, exciting stuff happening. You know, we got a movie coming out, a 20-year retrospective on the record, and we got a new Hiero Day, second annual Hiero Day coming out, and a bunch of good stuff.
Like I was saying, though, where were you the first time you heard 93 Till Infinity?
The first time I ever heard 93 to Infinity, I was 18 in Fort Worth, Texas, actually in East Fort Worth, and I was going to Polytechnic High School. One of my friends rolled up, and he put an album in, and it turns out that album changed my life. It was actually one of the first albums and songs that caused me as a teenager to see beyond where I was at, to see my future.
That's a great compliment, man. Well, I appreciate that. Damn. That was, I mean, at the time, that's not what we were trying to do. In hindsight, though, that's what we were trying to do. So that's a great compliment, man. I'm glad that you got dug it like that.
Well, you got to understand that a legacy that spans, a homegrown legacy that spans 20 years is very significant. One that even touches people out in the Midwest. I know many, because I come from the South, which is basically the Midwest. And over those years, I was influenced in many ways and captivated by what was going on here.
Man, it's crazy. We always get love out there, man. Like, always. And you got to look at it like, where we're from is all migrants. Everybody here is from the South and the Midwest. This is the last stop, kind of, you know. And these are the people who didn't come to Hollywood to be stars. They came up here to work in the shipyards and all that kind of stuff. So I see why that aesthetic carries across because of the link, you know. And it's, I mean, I see people in the Twitterverse, your Cosmic Trigger. Who else? We about to be down in Texas. I know it's a lot of love to cats down there, man. So, you know.
What's up? You going to Ohio, too?
Yeah. I think even we're doing a festival or something in Akron or something crazy like that, too. But we're going to be out there a couple times.
You all, as a group, are East Oakland natives. You want to let us know about the changes? Because many of the artists I have spoken with here in the past year have spoken on the big G word. So fill us in on that.
Well, I grew up, we all grew up really on 82nd and Astor, kind of. We're right now in the 50s, so this would be like Middle East kind of, you know? So that's more, a little bit deeper that way. Like, so we've been doing business here for the last, 20 plus years. We went to school here, you know. I mean, I went to college. I went to Stanford. I go to Cal now. So even my college education is local, you know. So we haven't really left. And I see a lot of changes in, I mean, they talk about gentrification, and I understand that. But I also see it from the side of, I know people whose grandmothers sold those houses. Or I know people whose grandmothers gave them their houses, and then they sold them, you know. So I see it happening, and the frustrating part of gentrification with me is that the people coming in a lot of times are scared. People, normal type people, are scared to live in the industrial areas or these warehouses and things like that, so they get these sort of fringe, you know, kind of Mad Maxi type dudes. You know what I'm saying, though? And so they're not cleaning up the area. They're not putting out lawns and yards. It's not kids playing in the yard and things like that. It's more of a I leave hella beer cans and all that shit. It's the ghetto. I don't give a fuck attitude. I leave bikes laying out and all that. So, and that's the frustrating part.
So correct me if I'm wrong. What I'm getting from that, real briefly here, is that are you saying that many of us outsiders are dirtying up Oakland?
When I say outsiders, I think a lot of it is, I mean, maybe it's guys who got laid off from the tech boom. Maybe it's guys who are fabricators and things of that nature. Maybe it's guys who moved to Oakland because the rent is cheaper than Frisco, you know?
You want to tell us a little bit about the Hieroglyphics Emporium, your online store?
Yeah, it's been up and running since 94, so it's almost 20 years old. Wow. We've been selling CDs, T-shirts. If you want Hiero stuff, go to shophiero.com or just go to hieroglyphics.com and click on Emporium. We got it, you know. New era snapbacks, V-necks, crew neck sweatshirts, hoodies, tees, shoes, you know, chucks, all kinds of stuff.
So from what I understand, you have a new album coming out?
Yes, sir. Rap Noir is me and Unjust, who produced for Chosen Few. We produced a lot of First Light albums. Got a group called Rap Noir. It's crazy. It's like a Hitchcock movie or something.
So in closing, is there anything that you'd like to go over? I mean, I usually don't leave the floor open for my guests like this, but since you are a legend from a legendary crew, I'm going to give you an opportunity to say whatever you'd like to say to our audience.
Oh, man. Hip-hop is fine. Create, you know, like, and hip-hop isn't just rap. It's all four elements of hip-hop, you know what I'm saying, though? And if you look around the world at the influence that the people of this culture, as far as the hip-hop culture, have on everything, we're selling everything from flat screens to, you know, hovering cars and stuff. You know, like, there's nothing that hip-hop's not touching. So if this is a culture that you love and express, do that daily or on a regular basis, and don't do it for the money. Do it because you love it, and the money will come.
All right. Is there any shout-outs you want to give?
Man, I got to give shout-outs to everybody on the interwebs, man. I love y'all out there, man. I live in my phone. I was trying to say, man, I only got one mode of speaking to the world. It's through my phone and then records, you know? Like, it's about it. And by the phone, I mean, I don't even want to give shout-out the application, but you feel me. I'm at Tajai Massey, you know? Hit me up, you know? I don't got TV. I don't got no radio. You feel what I'm saying, though? If I hear something new, it's because I click through to it.
All right. We'd like to thank you for being on the show today. And we will see you around the town. So this wraps our shoot with Tajai of the legendary Hieroglyphics Crew. Remember, friends, to keep it verdant, urban, and fun. This is Brent Green from thegreenscenetv.com.
GreenCTV.com.